Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I will be showing you how to download and install PyCharm IDE in Windows 10. Okay, so let's get started. So first, just go to Google and type download PyCharm. So you'll be getting the first link as jetbrains.com. Okay, just click it, download PyCharm. And in this, you'll be having two editions. Okay, one is professional and community. The professional edition is the paid one. Okay, you are just having a 30 days trial, and community edition is like free for use and it is built on open source. So just make sure that you have selected Windows OS, okay, and just click download in the community edition. So just click download, and it is about 378 MB in size. So just wait for some time for the download to get completed. So once your download is complete, just click it and open it. So we can also go to your downloads folder, okay, it will be there. You can just double click it and open it as well. Okay, that's not going to be an issue. So you'll be getting the PyCharm community edition setup, okay? So just click on next, and you need to just select the folder. I'm good with the default location itself. So if you want, you can just go click browse and maybe like select your location, okay? So for me it's okay, so I will just click on next, and here create a shortcut, just tick it, and add bin, okay, and .py as well, and just click on next and just click install. So pretty much a standard straightforward installation process, okay? So once your installation is complete, you need to reboot your system. So I will just select I want to manually reboot later. If you want, you can just reboot now as well. So I will just click on finish. Once you are done installing PyCharm IDE, the next important thing is that you need to check whether your system has Python, okay? Python installed. So to check that, it's really simple. Just go to start and type out Python. You'll be getting the like a Python 3.8 app. Or else what you can do is you can just go to command prompt, okay, just type cmd and open it. So here you can just type python hyphen hyphen version, okay? So you'll be getting the version of the Python that is installed on your system. In my case, I'm having Python 3.8. so in case if you aren't getting this one, what you can do is you can just go to browser again and you can just type download Python, and you'll be having this first link, okay, python.org. you can just select it, and you can just download the latest version. So the latest version is 3.10.4, or if you want to download any specific version, you can just scroll and download it from here. It's just a straightforward installation. Let me just open my PyCharm IDE, okay? Just type PyCharm, so you'll be having like this. Just click on open. It will be asking you import PyCharm settings. Just select do not import settings and just click OK. So now we are good to get started. It's showing us welcome to PyCharm. So at first we need to just create a new project, okay? So just click on this new project icon over here. And at first you want to just give the name of your project. So let me just give it as new pro, something like that. And here is the important thing, okay? You need to like the base interpreter, okay? So by default, it's just taking the path directly for me. It's Python 3.8. So for you, if it isn't showing, you need to just click it, or manually you need to browse the location of your Python version or a python.exe file like this. And if it isn't showing anything, like that means that you haven't installed your Python properly. So once you're done with this, just go to previously configured interpreter. Also go here and just click on this browse one and go to system interpreter. And you'll be having Python 3.8 over here as well. Just click OK for this that as well. And just click on create, OK. So at first it will take some time to load all the components and like index all the files. So just be patient. So once you don't have any loading bar over here, that means we are good to go, okay? And this is a default code that is being displayed over here. A main.py file is created and some sample code is also there. So first let's just remove this and let me just put a simple print statement. Print hello like that. And after doing this, just run it, okay? You'll be having this triangular icon. Just click it, and as you can see here, I will be getting the output over here, which means that we have successfully installed PyCharm as well as successfully configured Python into it. So if you are getting any error over here, you need to recheck your installation process, okay? So I hope you would have found this video useful. I have also done many other videos in Python, C, C++, Java, SQL queries, Node.js, MongoDB tutorials. So if you want, you can just check them out and subscribe me. Thanks for watching.